like you, Jehovah, there is no one like you. There is no one like you, Jehovah, there is no one like you. There is no one like you, Jehovah, there is no one like you. There is no one like you,
like you. No one is able to take the scroll. No one is able to take the scroll. We say in heaven and on earth, oh Jehovah, there is no. Say in heaven, hey Jehovah.
No one can take your place. No one can.
no one, oh.
There is no one like
you. No one can take your place. No one can take your place. No one. No one, oh.
There is no one
in our lives. No one can take your place. No one can take your place. No one, oh.
There is no one.
I, no one can take your place. No one can take your place. No one, oh.
There is no one.
I, no one can take your place. No one can take your place. Jehovah.
Been waiting for. PVC finally launches today, and today is our first service. Do you guys know what PVC stands for? Write it down on our chat box. Let's see if you guys know. Oh, I see. Couple answers already. Oh, yes. Here we go. It seems like you guys do know what PVC stands for. We also want to know where you're connecting from. Go ahead and write down where you're connecting from. We want to add you to our map. Do we have anybody from America? Or maybe from Africa? Or maybe all the way from the other side of the world? Do we have anybody from Asia? I don't know. You guys tell me where you guys are coming from. All right, it seems that we are a completely global community. I'm glad that you guys are joining us today from everywhere around the world. Now, let us quiet our hearts and join in unison prayer in the presence of God.
Hi everyone, I'm Andrew Cuevas, and I've had the privilege of knowing Dammy and Ope for a number of years as they started off as clients and now have become great friends. I am overjoyed to hear that they will be starting and leading the Prevailing and Borderless Church. I had the honor to speak to some of you about a year and a half ago about the importance of financial planning, and I'm always here as a resource if you ever need it. Speaking with Dammy and Ope about the PBC, I can tell they are overjoyed about this opportunity and they're going to do a wonderful job. They're both extremely passionate, not only about the church, but of course their faith. During this crazy time that our country and our world is facing, it's great that you guys are bringing some light and positivity. I wanted to share a quick prayer of encouragement. Lord of Hope, please encourage me with your love and truth. I ask that you lift me out of despair and worry. In these dark times, please console and guide me with your word. Help me to rise above my circumstances and place my confidence in your goodness and compassion. Holy Spirit, remind me that I can do all things through you. You are my strength and my song. Dammy and Ope, God has gifted you with the strength and ability to shine brightly in his world. May God continue to bless you with all good things you deserve. May the Holy Spirit fill your heart and grant you strength to do God's will. Best of luck to all of you on this wonderful achievement, and I can't wait to be able to join you one day. Thank you.
Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I want to pray for the Prevailing and Borderless Church. I pray for the leadership. I pray also for every member. I pray for everyone that the Lord has ordained to be part of this congregation. I pray for encouragement and protection for the leadership and the staff, for everyone. I pray for the spirit of wisdom, knowledge, and understanding in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In this church, Prevailing and Borderless Church, you have true and anointed worship in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. There will be powerful teaching of the word in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Insight into the word of God will prevail in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray for a spirit of unity for the membership, for every worker, for everyone that the Lord has called to minister in this congregation. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you have wisdom and discernment in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray for divine protection from the onslaught of the enemy. Every plan of the enemy concerning this church, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, it will not come to life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every plan of the evil one, every tree that the Lord has not planted in this house, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, they will be uprooted in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray also for great expansion. I pray for the influx of people eager to identify with the Almighty God and with the message of the Almighty God. I pray also for the administrative and managerial grace to come upon the church, to come upon the family in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In this new church, great breakthroughs will happen in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Healings will happen in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessing will happen in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Financial, material, spiritual blessing of all sorts in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. According to the word of God and according to the name of the church, I say Prevailing and Borderless Church. Indeed, indeed, the size will be borderless in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord will increase this family from every side in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This church will be the desire of all nations in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord will put his hand upon this church and make sure that it will flourish in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord God Almighty will expand the church round about in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Everything that the church leadership will need in order to carry out this assignment with all power, with all grace, and with all excellence, the Lord God Almighty will provide them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I plead the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ over this great idea, over this great innovation. I plead the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. The blood of the Lord Jesus Christ will keep it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Every plan of the enemy concerning will not see the light of the day in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The light of the Almighty God will shine upon this church, and every form of darkness will be thrown away in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It shall be well with everyone that comes into this. Everyone that joins this congregation, as they are joining this congregation in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, they will see the light of the Lord in everything that pertains to them in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray for strength. I pray for power. The power of the Almighty God will be in display, will be in power in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Round about, we'll always have reasons to glorify the name of the Lord concerning the Prevailing and Borderless Church in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Your expansion will know no limit in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray for Pastor Dammy, and the wife. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, it shall be well with you. The grace to see this dream come true and flourish, the Lord God Almighty will give it unto you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Dami Lola and Okpe, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord will strengthen you. The Lord will help you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord will walk with you. The Lord will walk with you in the name of the Lord Jesus. The Lord will walk for you in the name of the Lord. The Lord will take you by the hand in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. As you have started this work in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, even like Zerubbabel, even the hand of Zerubbabel that has started it will continue to walk with you to the end in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It shall be well with you. Whenever we hear concerning the Prevailing and Borderless Church, it shall be good news in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So shall it be. For we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Hi, friends. So recently, my good friend Dammy gave me a call and let me know that there was a movement happening. And I got really excited, not only because I get excited about movements, but because he said it was one that was prevailing and borderless. And of course, when I got to thinking about that, what is life to be lived borderless? Prevailing at times when borders are meant to keep us in or out of places. They're meant to say no, or sometimes they're meant to be overcome. Sometimes they can be helpful, but only when we learn and we rise above them together can they be things that we can cross without pain and without struggle. And even greater, when we can come together with purpose and with intention. So as I thought about that, I thought, well, maybe there are some words, maybe there is a song or a rhythm that might not just speak to me, but can speak to others in the same idea, the same spirit, same goal of living a life that is borderless and doing so together. So, without further ado, here it goes. I hope you enjoy it. I hope it speaks to you.
I kept you at the borders of my heart. It was lovely and lonely being right from the start. But touched death in the blinking of my eyes, and rigid words of being righteous fell apart. I've been trouble, I've been healing rain, I've been holy and broken, found my share of pain. When we walked, we parted waters, we sung and walls came down. What of all the signs and wonders? But if I got a song written in my heart, gotta know it says everything you are. Gotta feel it when you sing, it's like a prevailing wind. And if I got a song written in my heart, gotta know it says everything you are. Gotta feel it when you sing, it's like a prevailing wind. My brother, my sister may not look like me, but there's no flaws, no flaws that I can see. Yet the man on the screen said the king loved me best. He forgot the signs and wonders were for all of us. But if I got a song written in my heart, gotta know it says everything you are. Gotta feel it when you sing, it's like a prevailing wind. If I got a song written in my heart, gotta know it says everything you are. Gotta feel it when you sing, it's like a prevailing wind. this love, we will prevail over these walls, over ourselves. And by this love, we cannot fail. Our kingdom come is borderless. And by this love, we will prevail over these walls, over ourselves. And by this love, we cannot fail. Our kingdom come is borderless. Our kingdom come is borderless. 'Cause if I got a song written in my heart, gotta know it says everything you are. And gotta feel it when you sing. It's like a prevailing wind.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord Jesus. We thank God for the opportunity to be here today. We thank God for a dynamic and awesome PBC service launch so far. We are excited, as you can see. Praise God. We're moving now into the formal inauguration and blessing of the PBC and the Prevailing Borderless Church. And the anchor for this is our dear pastor who is birthing the province, Pastor Omotoso. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you. This is an awesome day without any doubt. And I know that something great is happening amongst humanity today. A new church that will take the Redeemed Christian Church of God to the ends of the earth is given birth to today. My own work is just to be a good midwife to make sure that the vessel that God has given this pregnancy to delivers this baby safely. And I want to use this opportunity to invite them to the stage so that we pray for them and we also inaugurate the PBC, the Prevailing Borderless Church of Redeemed Christian Church of God. Pastor Dammy and your wife, please come. I'd like you to rise on your feet, everybody. If you don't mind, just kneel down and just stretch out your hands towards them that the hand of God will be evident upon these vessels, that the Lord who has given them the vision for this new work will walk with them. They will not be tired. They will not be feeble. This vision is a vision that has no limit. Is a vision that extends to the ends of the earth. It has no territorial boundary. Nothing will be able to hinder it. No principality, no demon will be able to stop this vision. Lift up your voice and just begin to decree and declare over them and declare that the grace of God will abound in their lives in the name of Jesus. This work will flourish. This work will blossom. This work will excel in the mighty name of Jesus. The hand of God will be mighty upon them. Thank you, blessed Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I'm going to be inviting my wife to come and join me in laying hands on them. You will lay hand on the wife. I'll lay hand on Dammy. We're going to be, and I want you to just join us and decree and declare. These ones have been given a vision to do church that is borderless. It's going to be church that will be on the internet, church that from one location they can reach the entire world. They're going to be having congregation from Asia, from Africa, from Australia, from different parts of the world. They're going to have a location which is more like a studio from where they broadcast to the entire world. I want us to just decree that grace will be available to them, that the hand of God will rest upon them, that the favor of God will be upon them, that this work will blossom, this work will flourish, this work will shine in the name of Jesus. Nothing cancels insults better than results. This work will have results in the name of Jesus. You will not be tired. Your hand will not be feeble. You have laid your hand upon this plow. You will not look back. You will not draw back in the name of Jesus. That they will thank you. That they will bless you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I'm going to ask Pastor Felicia to pray and then I will pray.
Father, we want to thank you. We give you glory for this beautiful afternoon that this has been established. Daddy, we know that you ordained this before the foundation of the earth. And we thank you for making it come to pass. Thank you for your children that you have prepared for this assignment. Thank you for help on the throne of grace. You are the one that sent a person on an assignment and you back him or her up. Thank you for help on the throne of grace that will back up your children in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We decree concerning this work, according to the name, that it is a borderless church, which means it is ordained to reach the ends of the earth. So shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. Through this church, men and women that have not heard about the gospel before, they will hear the good news in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, please take it over. Advertise this yourself and let your name be glorified. You are a purposeful God. The purpose for this church will be accomplished in the name of Jesus. You will help your son and your daughter in the mighty name of Jesus. Wisdom and divine direction from the throne of grace you will give unto them. Thank you, Almighty Father. You will strengthen their arms. Their arms will not be weak. They will not give up. They will not faint at the time of challenges. In the name of Jesus, Daddy will thank you. Thank you, Almighty Father. We know the work is already settled. We know it is already done. And thank you for making your children to enter into your finished work. Be thou exalted, O Lord. Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Father eternal, we thank you. Thank you for the inspiration that brought this to be. Thank you for the day of conception. And thank you that today is the day of birth, the day of safe delivery. And thank you for making this day to happen. Thank you for giving this vision to your son and your daughter. Thank you because this work will prosper in their hands. Thank you because the name of the church is Prevailing Borderless Church. You said you will build your church and the gates of hell shall not prevail. This church will prevail. You will prevail over sickness. You will prevail over devils. You will prevail over territorial spirits. You will prevail over the works of darkness. You will prevail over worldliness. In the name of Jesus, you will usher men into the kingdom of God. In the name of Jesus, it shall be evident that God has made you more than conquerors. In the name of Jesus. And so, Lord, today we are declaring that a new grace, a new unction, come upon your son and upon your daughter, even to do exploits in the name of Jesus. We declare that from today, whatsoever they bind shall be bound, whatsoever they loose shall be loosed, whatsoever they decree shall be established in the name of Jesus. When they command to go, it will go. When they command to come, it will come in the name of Jesus. Nothing will be able to resist their voice in the name of Jesus. That they, when they call one, 1,000 shall answer in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Father. Thank you, King of Glory. And so today we dedicate to you and inaugurate the Prevailing Borderless Church in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And we declare that the words that you are using to nurse this church to maturity, to spread all over the world, that their hands are strengthened for the work in the name of Jesus. Everyone you will raise to come to team up with them in this assignment, you will strengthen their hands also. The people shall be willing. That is what your word says. In the day of your power, This is your day of power. Make people willing to team up with these ones in this new work in the name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Father. We command ancient doors to open. We command everlasting gates to be lifted. We command nations to bow to you. You said we should ask of the heathen for an inheritance. You see, give us the uttermost parts for an inheritance. Lord, we are asking that you will give us the nations. You will give us the heathen. You will give us the Gentile nations. They will surrender to us in the name of Jesus, that they will thank you. We bless your name. Let PBC flourish. Let it blossom. Let it be great. Let there be results that will cancel every argument. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I'm going to ask all the pastors that are in the house to come on the altar and to lift them up and congratulate them into this new assignment. All pastors, you can come. Keep clapping. Keep celebrating Jesus. We'll be bringing the message shortly. But without any doubt, God has started a great thing. And the good work God has started will flourish even before our very eyes in the name of Jesus. God is going to walk with you. The hand of God will support you. The hand of God will uphold you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. God bless you.
And wherever you're listening to us, open your mouth and pray in the Holy Ghost with understanding. Pray in the Holy Ghost with understanding. Know that you're not praying to yourself. You're praying unto the Lord. Scripture says, he that prayed in an unknown tongue speaketh unto the Father. Scripture says, we do not know how to pray as we ought, but the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groanings that cannot be uttered. So wherever you are, engage the Spirit of God right now. Honestly, the Spirit of God is with you, but you just have to deliberately engage him. He's right there waiting for your invitation. He's just waiting for your invitation. He's always waiting. He said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man will open up to me, I will come. I will come in, and me and my Father will dine with him. Me and my Father will talk to him. So God is ever, ever waiting for us. He's ever waiting. We just need to know that. So open your mouth, pray in the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Matayanes Rado Satayananos Aye Sados Aye Sados Abali Kapaya Labarondo Zakie to Palianos Jadasa Jadasu Tayaninandes Balie Kopaina Nosa Tayanes Oh Sadiano Hali Tayana Nananisa Elada Baye Yado Ayo Sati Ayo Sati Ananisa
Somehow we have, I'm trying to find the right word to use. We have kind of, I don't want to use the word bastardized, but or misunderstood. I'm trying to find the right word, but somehow the concept of church, we have gotten it wrong somewhere. That's the truth. We have gotten the concept of church wrong somewhere. We have focused on the minor, right? And left the major. So when you find churches, we are more concerned about the buildings than the people. Meanwhile, God, when God was speaking, when Jesus was speaking, he was speaking to Peter. And he says, upon you, I'll build my church, and the gate of hell will not prevail. But what we have right now is the organization. We are more concerned about the workings of the organization or the organizational part of church. So things are running smoothly. The ACs work. The light works. You know, the car parks, people can come with, you know, their children departments. There are different parts. You know, that we are concerned about different groups and different groups in the church. The facility of the church, how the church is working and running. We have edifices, big, big, big buildings that need a lot to run. I mean, if you live in Nigeria, I know you don't live in Nigeria for some of you because this is going to the ends of the earth, but I live in Nigeria. If you live in Nigeria, I mean, we have edifices, we have to use generator to power because we barely have light sometimes. And, you know, to run that generator, you have to get diesel. Sometimes we don't even have diesel, for some it's fuel. But all of these things, I believe, is to make a place conducive for people to come and worship. And honestly, the people coming to worship, they don't live in church. I'm talking about the organization. Nobody lives in church. If you'll agree with me, nobody lives in church building. We just come to meet. People go out. People go into life. People do their business in life. And so sometimes we are focused more on the church and the once or twice we meet. And I'm talking about the building than the people who would take the word and the message to the ends of the earth, who would take the word and the message to their workplace, who would take the word and the message to their offices, their business places, the marketplace, in every other area. We have not equipped them as much as we have equipped our buildings. Our buildings are good looking. We change the chairs. We make it more comfortable. We increase the AC. The people sometimes are even too cold to worship their God. But we haven't spent time to to build the people so that when they are out, when they are faced with challenges, when they are faced with, you know, all manner of things, they can stand. And somehow the Lord used COVID to bring our minds to that reality. We had buildings, but we couldn't go. We had buildings, we couldn't go there. And so suddenly, church online became a new and more encouraged and normal thing. And people began to realize, or began to realize, that they can actually serve and worship the Lord wherever they are. They can actually know the Lord wherever they are. They can actually hold up His banner wherever they are. And people started to find God themselves. And I believe that's why Prevailing Borderless Church is starting. It is not to do the numb again. We have branches. We keep opening branches. It's not to do the numb again. It's not to do the numb again. It is Prevailing Borderless. So when you go online, you can literally reach different part of the world. Thank God for technology. Through Jesus. And so you realize that when you come online, when you go on air, what you say, what you do is important, because you can literally affect the people and change their lives. And so with COVID, we began to change our orientation to understand that we need to focus more on the people. Focus more on the people. Build the people. Let them have stamina. Scripture says they that know their God will be strong and they will do exploit. Not they that know their church building. They that know their God. They don't know the Bible. They don't know what the word of the Lord says. They will be strong and they will do exploit. And that's the reason we are singing this song. So that you have understanding. And you understand that you are the church. I am the church. And scripture says the church of the Lord will prevail. And the gate of hell will not be able to stand it. So we say, Lord, let your church prevail in every land, in every city. Let your church prevail in every land, in every city. Let your people who are your church prevail in every land and in every city. Let your truth spread across the nations of the earth. Let your message go across the nations of the earth. Let truth not be ignored. I will build my church, thus says the Lord. They will raise my banner in all the earth. If I believe it up, I'll draw men to the fount of life, the fount of peace. See, I will build my church, thus says the Lord.
grow from coast to coast, so the men are saved and they are changed. Let your message grow from coast to coast, so the men are saved and they are changed. Let your message grow from coast to coast, so the men are changed and saved. Hold on, I let your message grow from coast to coast, so the men are changed and they are saved. Let your message grow.
Bye.
God is the fix. We need him cause we are broken. God has made a way so we can live. If we just believe in Jesus' name. God is the potter. You and I are the clay. God is the fixer. You and I are the broken. God has made a way so we can live. If we just believe in Jesus' name. God is the potter. You and I are the clay. God is the fixer. You and I need him cause we are broken. He has made a way. He's the way, the truth, and the life. Oh. God is the potter. You and I are the clay. Allow the potter fix you. Allow the potter mend you. Allow the potter fix you. Allow the potter mend you. Allow him, yeah. So let your church prevail in every land. So the gate of hell cannot prevail. Let your message grow from coast to coast. So the men are saved and they are changed. So the men are saved and they are changed. So the men are saved. So we say, oh, believe it. Above all other gods, we lay our crowns in worship. You, we say, oh, believe it. Above all other gods. We lay our crowns Savior, you believed it. Jesus, you believed it. Halana maya kota. Hola da 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 ba. Oh, Jesus, you believed it. You believed it. Jesus is famous. Even the ones that refuse to believe him know that he exists and know that he is Lord. That's why they fight it. Their flesh fights it. So we pray for you that you stay with Jesus and you will not deviate. In Jesus' name we have prayed. God bless you, my friend. Pastor Dammy and your lovely wife. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We just want to say thank you, Jesus, for what God has done in this place, even today. It's a remarkable thing that the Prevailing Borderless Church is inaugurated today. I congratulate Dammy and I congratulate the wife. The Lord will bless you mightily. And this work that God has committed into your hands, the Lord himself will strengthen you to accomplish in the name of Jesus. There are many people that may be wondering, what is the borderless church? Why do we even need to have a borderless church? What's it all about? Before I go into my message today, I'd like to answer some of those questions by something I had put together. Theologians worldwide in the missional and evangelical work have come to a conclusion that the global movement of people is divinely orchestrated. They say that these movements of people, which many times are through immigration, through a growing interest in furthering education, through interest in seeking better economic opportunities, or through other means that we may not like, other means such as war, pestilence, famine, drought, natural disaster, genocide, political upheavals, like the recent displacement of over 6 million Ukrainians from their country, even to other parts of the world. These theologians have concluded that this massive movement of people is orchestrated by God. And they say that in each case, whether by choice or by force, people on the move uproot themselves from their traditional cultures and they replant themselves in soils that is foreign to their own. We may not like to believe it, but many of these people movements are orchestrated for the spread of the gospel. God is continuing to use turbulent events to displace refugees outside their familiar borders of their homelands, but within reach of Christians in local churches. Many of these refugees originate from nations that are untouched, nations that are unreached, nations that in the missional world, you will say, they can be reached places. Many of these uprooted peoples are being replanted in very stable environments where Christianity has had a very long foothold, a very strong foothold over many years. Nations like America, where Christianity has had foothold for a long time, many people are being replanted there. For example, people movement from war in Syria, people movement from war in Iraq, people movement from war in Afghanistan, and people movement from the unrest in Somalia directly plant the citizens of this nation as immigrant refugees in parts of the world that Christianity is standing. Many are planted in different nations of Europe, and many particularly in America. Now, this people movement has encouraged, has also encouraged what we call the reverse missional phenomenon, which makes nations in the third world, so to say, that are thriving, that are charismatic in nature, to also bring believers, Christians, into the first world where the love for the gospel and the love for church is becoming cold. So people movement has the hand of God in it, whether by force, whether by coercion, or whether people move willingly. It's God that is making people to move. And every time people move, the gospel moves. The gospel moves. I want you to please know that the dispersion or the scattering of people in various parts of the world, occurring either by voluntary act or by coercive conditions, now necessitate that the present-day church planting approach should become borderless. should become transnational and should not just be a destination where people go. The church today has to become multicultural. It has to become homogeneous. The church today has to become the church that is multi-ethnic. It has to become that church that has different approaches to reaching people. Because you now find out that in many nations of the world, people they will have called foreigners before are now part of their nation. I pray today that what Dammy and the wife are starting with this prevailing borderless church, the breath of God will be upon it. And when you now look at this people movement and you look at the advent of technology that is available in the palms of everyone that is listening to me, everyone in the world, there is one device or the other in your hand by which you can reach the ends of the earth at the click of a button. And please, you will understand that that has made it very veritable tool for evangelism, very veritable tool for doing the church work. It's the process of bringing the world or globe to the local church. The local church. We are having church in this facility now, this day, and from here we are reaching out to the ends of the earth. Who knows how many people we are touching their lives already? And so it's an opportunity to reach the world. It's an opportunity for also to bring the world into our local sphere. And I want to thank the Lord that this move has started. I'm going to read a scripture to you from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 8, in between verse 1 and verse 6. The Bible says, Saul was consenting unto his death. This was the death of Stephen. And at the time, there was a great persecution against the church, which was at Jerusalem. And they were all scattered abroad throughout the regions of Judea and Samaria, except the apostles. They were all scattered abroad throughout all the region of Judea, Samaria, except the apostles. And devout men carried Stephen to his burial and made great lamentation over him. As for Saul, he made havoc of the church, entering into every house, and hailing men and women, committed them to prison. Therefore, they that were scattered abroad went everywhere preaching the word. They that were scattered abroad went everywhere preaching the word. Then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ unto them. And the people with one accord gave heed unto those things which Philip spake, hearing and seeing the miracles which he did. I read this scripture to let you understand that every time people are scattered, every time people are moved, every time people are massively moved from nation to nation, is an opportunity for the gospel to spread. You may not like what is going on in Ukraine right now, but the gospel will surely spread. You'll be amazed how God will use what has happened or what is happening right now to take the gospel to Europe, to light up Europe with fire again. Ukraine as a nation, you know that the fire of the Holy Ghost has been burning there for a while. Those people who are displaced going to the rest of Europe are going to set that continent on fire for the Lord. And many that are hearing me today are going to be tools in the hand of God. In Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, when you read in verse 8, the Bible says you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and you shall be witness unto me, both in Jerusalem, in all Judea, in Samaria, and to the uttermost parts of the earth. And so you know the disciples, after the Holy Ghost came upon them, in Acts chapter 2, the Bible says they decided to stay in Judea. They decided to continue to stay where they were. They were comfortable. They enjoyed the power of the Holy Ghost. Peter was doing exploits. 3,000 gave their life to Christ the first time. 5,000 gave their life to Christ the second time. And then they were, the shadow of Peter was healing the sick, and they couldn't count the number of people that were giving their life to Christ. But God wanted the gospel to go beyond Judea. He wanted the gospel to go beyond Jerusalem. He wanted the gospel to go beyond Judea. He wanted the gospel to go to Samaria. He wanted the gospel to go to the uttermost parts of the earth. You may be wondering, what can be the fastest way by which the gospel can reach this place? God decided to scatter his people. He brought something that happened. Saul, who became Paul later, was part of those that was consenting to the scattering of the church. We thank God today that in America, where this PBC is starting, the Prevailing Borderless Church, there is peace in the land. We are not scattered. But people are scattered all over the world. And people have been brought to America from different parts of the world. And from this nation where peace is residing, by the help of technology, we can take the gospel to the ends of the earth. So the borderless church is being born today because God wants the gospel to spread. And the Bible says everywhere Philip went into, he went into Samaria. Bible says great joy came upon that city. I declare to you that great joy will come to people in every city that PBC will enter in the name of Jesus. Through the effort of PBC, you will reach the cities of the world. You will reach the nations of the world. You will go to the ends of the earth. Nothing will be able to stop you. We have already prayed for you. We've inaugurated PBC. It has started already. And please understand that there is a backing of the Holy Ghost behind you. And heaven will back you up in the name of Jesus. Let me go to my message for today. I just said I should answer the question on why do we need a borderless church? Or what does a borderless church all entail? And I believe you have an idea what it entails now. It's a way by which God takes advantage when people are scattered. And he moves all over the world so that the whole world can turn to the Lord. I pray today that as you hear the message God has prepared for us, he will touch your heart. And what am I going to be praying about or teaching about or preaching about today? It's something from the book of Isaiah, Isaiah chapter 6, verse 1 down to verse 9. I'll read a few verses there and then we continue. Father, we thank you for what you have already done in our midst. Thank you for the inauguration of PBC, the Prevailing Borderless Church. Thank you for your son, Dammy. Thank you for your daughter, Ola. Thank you for what you are going to use them to accomplish in the world. This is a seed being planted. We ourselves don't even know to what extent it can reach, but we are declaring that this church, there is no limitation to it. There is no border that can stop it. There is no immigration issue that can hinder it. This church is going to the ends of the earth in the name of Jesus. The Redeemed Christian Church of God will spread to the ends of the earth through the vehicle of PBC in the name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I titled my message today on who will go for us. Who will go for us? You know that scripture very well in Isaiah chapter 6. The Bible says in verse 1, he said, in the year that King Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Then in verse 5, the Bible says, then said I, woe is me, for I'm undone, because I'm a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with the tongs from off the altar. And he laid it upon my mouth and said, lo, this hath touched thy lips, and thy iniquity is taken away, and thy sin purged. Also I heard the voice of the Lord say, whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then said I, here am I, send me. And he said, go and tell these people, hear ye indeed, but understand not. See ye indeed, but perceive not. I believe that this is the mandate that has been given to Dammy. I believe this is the mandate that has been given to the wife. I believe this is the mandate of God to go and declare to the people that they have been looking, but they have not been seeing. That they have been hearing, but they have not been understanding. That it is time for their culture to change. It is time for there to be clarity. It is time for them to know the truth. And it is the truth that will make them free. The Bible says that before Isaiah could be sent, he had to acknowledge that he was a man of unclean lips and he was in the midst of a people that were unclean. And before he could also be sent again, fire had to touch his mouth to purge him of every iniquity and to get him ready. And heaven said, who will I send? And in this
times that there is so much scattering all over the world, in this time that there's so much confusion, in this time that there's so much peril, and people don't have an answer, government don't have an answer, the United Nations don't have an answer, they don't know what to do about Ukraine, the governments of the world don't know what to do about even gun violence everywhere, but there's a God in heaven that has an answer, and he's going to use the occasion, the situation that the world is going through, even to spread the gospel and to bring people back to Christ, bring people back to the Lord. And God is asking, who can I send? I believe he has found Dammy, but I'm asking today, who else is he going to find in this congregation, in the world, that will be ready to join this team and say, I can be a tool to be used to spread the gospel, even to the unreached, to spread the gospel to the ends of the earth, to spread the gospel to everyone where they are. I pray in the name of Jesus that God will find you. Do you know that when God took Philip, he went to Samaria, that was in the last assignment. After Philip had preached to the people in Samaria and they had given their life to Christ, the Bible says in verse 26, the angel of the Lord spake unto Philip, saying, arise, go towards the south, unto the way that goeth down from Jerusalem unto Gaza. That's Acts of the Apostles, chapter 8, when you read in verse 26. And he said in verse 27, and he arose and went, and behold, a man of Ethiopia, an eunuch of great authority under Candace, queen of the Ethiopians, who had the charge of all her treasure and had come to Jerusalem for to worship, was returning and sitting in his chariot, read Isaiah the prophet. Then the Spirit said unto Philip, go near and join yourself to his chariot. And Philip ran thither to him and heard him read the prophet Isaiah, and said, understand thou that thou readest? And verse 31, and he said, how can I, except some man should guide me? And he desired Philip that he will come up and sit with him. There are many people of import, there are many people of authority who are looking for good, great answers, the truth. They are looking for God. And this man was a ruler looking for God, but then he was reading the Bible, reading the scriptures, and didn't understand what he was reading. But the Holy Spirit ordered the steps of Philip to where this man was. I pray today, Dammy, that the Holy Spirit will lead you to everyone that needs understanding of the scripture, understanding of the word of God, that needs clarity, even in the things of God, that needs to understand the proverbs that are written in scripture. The book, the Bible, is a mystical book. It requires somebody that has been held by the Holy Spirit to give interpretation and understanding to those who want that understanding. I pray that God will use you, will lead you. The Bible says, as many that are led by the Spirit of God, they are called the sons of God. But the Bible also tells us that in Romans chapter 10, when you read from verse 13, he said, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord, he said, they are the ones that shall be saved. But he now went on. He said, how can they call on him whom they have not believed? And how can they believe in him whom they have not heard? And how can they hear if somebody does not preach to them? And how can somebody preach to them except that person is sent? And that is why God is saying, who will I send? Who will go for me? Who will go for us? Who will go and explain the scripture to people? God is not asking you to do something extraordinary. He's simply saying, I'm looking for people to send, to go and explain the scripture that is written to many people that are out there that don't have the understanding. And that is all you are called to do, Dammy. That's all you are called to do, people of God, that we join this team of the Prevailing Borderless Church to explain what God has written, so that souls that are thirsty can be filled, so that souls that are hungry can be satisfied, so that souls that are yearning for God can get that yearning satisfied. I pray this day that the hand of God will find you. The hand that found Isaiah will find you. But I want you to please understand, you can't be sent without first being changed. That's very important. Only vessels that are transformed, only vessels that are changed, that are the vessels that can be used. The Bible says in Romans chapter 12, When you read in verse 2, he said, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. It is in the process of you being transformed that you can prove what is that good and what is that acceptable and what is that perfect will of God to humanity. Isaiah could not be sent until he was transformed. Iniquity had taken him over. But do you know, the moment he acknowledged that he was a man of iniquity and he needed the help of God, the hand of God touched his mouth, and he said in verse 6, then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having live coal in his hand. Isaiah 6, verse 6, having live coal in his hand, which he had taken with the tongues from off the altar, and he laid it upon my mouth and said, lo, this hath touched thy lips, your iniquity is taken away, your sin is purged. The moment you remove iniquity, even from the affairs of man, a change comes, transformation comes. A change that the first change you need is the iniquity must be eradicated. You can't be sent until that is done. Another thing is, you can't be sent until fear is taken away. In Jeremiah chapter 1, between verse 4 and verse 12, Jeremiah said, I'm a little child, I cannot go. And God said to Jeremiah, say not that you are a child. Verse 7, he says, say not that I'm a child, for thou shalt go to whosoever that I command, that I send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord. Then in verse 9, the Bible says, then the Lord put forth his hand and touched his mouth. And the Lord said unto him, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth. See, I have this day set thee over the nations, over the kingdoms, to root out, to pull down, to destroy, to throw down, to build, and to plant. And I pray today that you will understand why this church, it's not just called the borderless church, it's called the prevailing borderless church. The reason is, fear has been taken away. They are not afraid of the people they are sent to. The Bible says Jeremiah's mouth was touched and the word of God was put in his mouth. And God says, see, this day I have set you over the nations. I have set you over the kingdoms. I have set you over the cities to root out. That is a sign of prevailing. To pull down, to destroy, to throw down, to build, and to plant. You will prevail, Dammy. You will prevail in this assignment. Every city, every nation you go into, you are prevailing in the name of Jesus. This church shall be a prevailing church in the name of Jesus. I want you to please understand that fear is taken away. Iniquity is purged. Then you are ready for the assignment. You are ready for the assignment. You are ready to take the gospel to the ends of the earth. The Holy Ghost, he said, you will receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you. Then you shall be witnesses of me in Judea, in Samaria, and the uttermost parts of the world. Technology is going to make it possible for us to be witnesses of Jesus to the uttermost parts of the earth. Where you couldn't reach, you even physically, this church will get there in the name of Jesus. You will find out that at the click of a button, you can reach the ends of the earth. And I pray today that the Lord is taking us to the ends of the earth in the name of Jesus. So like I said earlier, for you to be an instrument of change, even in this borderless church, for God to find you, you must first be changed. And the Holy Spirit is the agent of change. In 2 Corinthians chapter 3, the Bible says in verse 17, it said, now the Lord is that Spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. Then he said, but we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass, the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory. The goal of the Most High is that we will be like him. The ultimate change is that we will become, we'll be like Jesus. We are not yet there. We are in the process. And this is work in progress. In 1 John chapter 3, when you read in verse 2, it said, beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when we shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. We don't yet know what we shall be like, but we are not yet there what we think we should be, but we know know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him. I say that change is continuous. God is still working on me. God is still working on you. And that change is a continuous change. Every day he's transforming us. Every day he's changing us. Every day he's moving us. Greater and greater change is occurring in our lives. I pray in the name of Jesus that that change will be evident in the mighty name of Jesus in your lives, in the name of Jesus. And that is why he said, don't go until you endure with power from on high. Because there is a fire that changes people. The spirit of change, the Holy Ghost, must first encounter you, purge you, take away iniquity, transform you, turn you into another man. When Saul was going to become king, in 1 Samuel in chapter 10, the Bible says that Samuel said to him that after the Spirit of God comes upon him, he shall be transformed into another man. He said, from that moment, do as occasion demands, for God is with you. I pray today that you too will be transformed into the tool God wants to use in the name of Jesus. In the book of Malachi in chapter 3, between verse 2 and verse 3, the Bible talks about a fire of change. He said, but who may abide the day of his coming? And who shall stand when he appeareth? For he is like a refiner's fire, and like a fuller's soup. And he shall sit as a refiner and purifier of silver. And he shall purify the sons of Levi and purge them as gold and silver, that they may offer unto the Lord an offering in righteousness. Everyone hearing me, there is a fire that will purge you. There is a fire that will change you. There is a fire that will turn you around. In that Malachi 3, when you read in verse 6, he said, for I am the Lord, I change it not. He said, therefore you sons of Jacob are not consumed. He is the one that can change a king and make him a beast, and can make that beast to become a king back. That was what he did to Nebuchadnezzar. He is the one that can change the enemy of the gospel to become an apostle and an instrument of the gospel. He took Saul, who was the one that caused the church to be scattered, to become a major writer of the gospel, to become the apostle to the Gentiles. What am I saying? There is nobody beyond what God can use. God can change you. He changed a prostitute to become the treasurer of the kingdom. You remember Mary Magdalene, who was with Jesus? God is in the business of changing people. Do you remember that the first person that went to heaven with Jesus was a robber, a thief, even on the cross? He changed the thief even at the last minute to make sure that that thief did not miss eternity in heaven. I pray today that change is coming to you in the name of Jesus. Change is transforming you. Change is making you to become a tool that God can use in the name of Jesus. But I want to give you a warning, and the warning is simple. Some people are meant to change the world, but the world is changing them. The world is changing them. And that is why I want you to be careful your association. Whatever you spend time with will change you. Bible says in 1 Corinthians 15 verse 33, he said, be not deceived. Evil communications corrupt good manners. You can't tell yourself that you are immune even to change. Everyone wants to change you. But I also tell you, the devil wants you changed also. The world wants you changed. The enemy wants you changed. In the New Living Translation, that 1 Corinthians 15:33 says, don't be fooled by those who say such things, for bad company corrupts good character. People of God, you want to be an instrument for God to use in the PBC, in the borderless church, in this end time, then your company must change. Your association must change. In 2 Corinthians, in chapter 3, verse 18, the Bible makes us to understand what we call the law of transformation. And what is that law of transformation? Whatsoever you focus on, whatsoever you keep looking at, you will soon become. Whatsoever gets your attention is going to get your heart. And whatsoever gets your heart is going to transform you, change your life. Somebody said the heart of the matter is the matter of the heart. And that's why the Bible says, guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it flows what? The issues of life. You remember Samson? The Bible makes us to understand that Samson was meant to change the world, but the world ended up changing him. In Judges chapter 13, when you read in verse 5, God sent the angel and said to the parents, "For lo, thou shalt conceive and bear a son, and no razor shall come on his head. For the child shall be a Nazarite unto God from the womb, and he shall begin to deliver Israel out of the hand of the Philistine." Samson was sent to deliver Israel from the hand of the Philistine. But look at what happened to Samson. He ended up looking for marriage in the camp of the Philistine. When you read in Judges in chapter 14, the Bible went on. The parents told him, "Did you find any other woman in Israel that you could marry? How come you are going to the unbeliever?" But Samson was determined, "Marry her for me." It was in the camp where he was supposed to be a minister of change. It was that camp that changed him. The Bible says in Judges chapter 16, when you read in verse 19, "And she made him sleep upon her knees, and she called for a man, and she caused him to shave off the 7 locks of his head, and she began to afflict him, and his strength went from him. And she said, 'The Philistines be upon this Samson.' And he awoke out of his sleep and said, 'I will go out as at other times before and shake myself.' And he knew not that the Lord was departed from him." He was sent to change the situation of Israel with the Philistines, but the Philistines ended up changing him. You have been sent, PBC, to the world, but I pray that the world will not change you, that you will be determined, you will correct your association, you will not focus on worldly approaches even to do the gospel work. You will be determined that this work will be done by the guidance of the Holy Spirit. You will focus on God. Human efforts don't work. They don't work. The Holy Ghost is the true change agent. He's the true change agent. And so if you want to really change any environment, you have to depend on the Holy Ghost. In 2 Corinthians chapter 3, in verse 6, the Bible says, "Who also had made us able ministers of the New Testament, not of the letter, but of the Spirit." He said, "For the letter killeth, but the Spirit giveth life." The Spirit giveth life. So the one who is going to give life to the world, the change that God is bringing, is a change that brings life. And that change is from his word. And the Bible says the letter will kill. So it's not every oratory word that gives life. It's not every word that is enticing to the hearts of men that gives life. The one that gives life is the one incubated by the Holy Ghost. The one you receive by the Holy Spirit. No wonder the Bible says in John chapter 6, when you read in verse 63, he said, "It is the Spirit that quickeneth." He said, "The flesh profits nothing." He said, "The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life." Don't just speak to people. Don't just preach to people. Make sure what you are speaking and preaching is the word of life. Make sure what you are speaking and preaching is spirit and life. Is the word given to you by the Holy Ghost. Is the word given to you by God himself. And I know that once it is birthed by God, once it is God giving you that word, the life in the world, the rhema in the world, the zohe in the world, we enter into the people and we change them. Somebody said there is so much church in the world. In fact, somebody said it this way. He said the world has become churchy and the church has become worldly. It's the reason is simple. When the church begins to look at the world for solution, for examples, for what to do, for inspiration of what to do, then those worldly things will begin to happen in the church. And there's so much church in the world, but the world is not changing. Why? The reason is simple. The church, who is supposed to be a change agent to the world, a light to the world, is no longer taking direction from the Holy Spirit. The church is now looking at the world to be able to find solutions to the issues of men. But there is no solution in the world. The only place where there's solution is in Christ Jesus. Is in Christ Jesus. Is in Christ Jesus. The spirit of change. The spirit of the living God. I pray this day that the mercy of the living God, that the fire of change will enter into you. You will carry that spirit of change. Everywhere you go to speak, every time you share the word on this PBC platform, even to the rest of the world, it shall be word that will change the hearts of men, that will change the lives of men in the name of Jesus. That is why the Bible says, wait for the promise. Wait for the promise of the Father. Wait to be endued with power from on high. And the moment you carry that power, tongues of fire, we set the whole world on fire in the name of Jesus. The spirit of change, we envelope the world. You become an instrument of change. You will not be changed. It is the world that will be changed by you. I want us to just trust the Lord this day, even as we declare that as many that are hearing me today, whether you are online, whether you are in the sanctuary where we are gathered here today, you will decide, I am here, send me. Here, who is the Lord going to send? Who shall I send? Who will go for us? That is the topic we are sharing today. And as many that are saying, I am here, send me, then you will say, I want to be an agent of change, an instrument of change. I surrender to the Holy Spirit. I want you to lift up your voice right now and say, Holy Spirit, incubate my life, incubate my home, incubate me, O Lord. Let the Spirit of God envelope me in the name of Jesus. I want to be that instrument of change that will turn nations around, that will turn cities around in the name of Jesus. I say, I want to be that instrument of change in the name of Jesus. The world will try to change you, but the Spirit of God will keep you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I will conclude my message today this way. What changes the world is result. Result of the Holy Ghost. Result of the Holy Ghost. And I'm prophesying over PBC that we will see result in short time. In the book of Isaiah, when you read in chapter 2, between verse 2 and verse 3, he said, it shall come to pass in the last days, these are the last days, that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow into it. And many people shall go and say, come ye, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, to PBC. And he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. This is your calling, sir. This is what you are asked to do. Just teach the word. Make sure the word you are teaching is inspired by the Holy Ghost. And as you teach that word, you explain the scriptures, you will find out people will come. Results will be evident. All Peter preached in Acts of the Apostles chapter 2 was to teach the word, the scriptures. He just referred them to the book of Joel, referred them to the book of Isaiah. He said, this is what had been spoken of by the prophet, and 3,000 were convicted. You don't need to add anything to the gospel. The gospel is complete in itself. It's complete in itself. And I know results will follow. Even this that has started here, in the name of Jesus. People will come and say, we have heard that God is in this place. We have heard that just by breaking down the scriptures, explaining the truth of God, that miracles are happening. And you will see people gathering from all over the world to join the PBC. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will keep you. Results will back up your effort in the name of Jesus. When people see results, arguments will end. Somebody said, nothing cancels insult better than result. And he also said, nothing cancels argument better than result. This church, PBC, will be characterized by results in the name of Jesus. Results of healing, results of deliverance, results of growth and enlargement in the name of Jesus. God bless you. It is well with you in Jesus' name. I will congratulate you one more time. And I just say to you, today is a great day in your life and ministry. The Lord will back you up in Jesus' name. Wow. Amen.
What a powerful warning season. Thank you, Jesus, for such a great launch. Now, coming up next, a wonderful minister will lead us into some offerings and songs. But don't go anywhere. Pastor Manita is coming up next, and you don't want to miss her. Make sure that you enjoy the service until then. We prevail.
Praise the Lord, everyone. God bless you. Hallelujah. We celebrate with Pastor Dammy, even as you embark on this new journey. We just pray that the Lord, who sent a man and goes ahead of him, has gone ahead of you, and he shows forth his power. Everybody, wherever you are, can we just celebrate Jesus? Exalt him. Exalt him. He is good. He is good. He is good. He is good. Oh, we lift you high, Jesus. We lift you high, oh God. For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. Hey. For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. Yeah, 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 yeah. Kobarana namasida. Yeah. For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, for you are good and your mercy endures forever. Yeah. Forever, Alpha and Omega, Alpha and Omega. Oh, for you are good, and your mercy endures forever. Oh, Alpha and Omega. Alpha and Omega. For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. Alpha and Omega. You are good and your mercy endures forever, Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. For you are good and your mercy endures forever, Alpha and Omega. You sit in heaven and make the earth your footstool. Alpha and Omega, Kubarata Pasina. Lord, you are good. Alpha and Omega. Lord, you are good. Oh, and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. Alpha and Omega. Alpha, my beginning. Omega, you're my very end. You are worthy to be praised. Holy. For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. for you are city whose builder and maker is God. Can you declare that it is Alpha and Omega? For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. Yeah, let's raise it. Oh, for you are God, and you will see you. And you, Alpha and Omega, Alpha and Omega. Lord, you are so good, and you will see you. Lord, you are good, and your mercy and yours. I come before my God and King, the one who gave his life for me. I'll raise the banner of his name. The nations call on him. I come before my God and King. the one who gave his life for me. I'll raise the banner of his name until the nations come. The champion of the host above and captain of my destiny. In you alone I make my voice. You reign alone as Lord, for you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. Oh, for you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. Alpha and Omega.
For you are good and your mercy endures forever. Alpha and Omega. Randele kipi ananama. Eba rata basuma. Go ahead and pray the Holy Ghost. I will pray the Spirit, and I will pray the understanding also. I will sing in the Spirit, I will sing in the understanding also. Ela tori ena nasie.
Thank you for your tender mercy. Thank you for your grace. thank you for your unfailing love. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Congratulations, congratulations, congratulations. The day has finally come, and I celebrate with you, Pastor Dammy, and your wife, Okwe, on this occasion of the inauguration of the Prevailing and Borderless Church of the RCCG. As you and your family embark on this exciting journey of a new form of church, my prayer for you is that God will enable you to reach thousands, perhaps even millions of people for Christ in our lost world. It shall go far beyond what you can even see or imagine in Jesus' name. The Bible says in Revelations 3, verses 7 to 8, Revelations 3, verses 7 to 8, these are the words of him who is holy and true, who holds the key of David. What he opens, no one can shut, and what he shuts, no one can open. Verse 8 says, I know your deeds. See, I have placed before you an open door that no one can shut. I know you will have little strength, yet you have kept my word and have not denied my name. Now, looking at verse 8 of that Revelations chapter 3, God is saying, I know you don't have it all together or have all the answers, but you are faithful. Pastor Dammy, the truth of the matter is that you have been faithful in reaching out and sharing the gospel of Christ to lost souls all over the world through different programs you've held over the years. And God is about to take it to another level. You will surely reap the rewards of your labor in Jesus' name. God is saying, I know you aren't strong in every area as you stand against culture. And as you know, this new church is counterculture. But you have stayed true. God will surely see you through the details of all that will be involved, and he will send destiny helpers for this new venture in Jesus' name. God is finally saying, I realize that you're not perfect, but I am going to open a door of opportunity before you, and it is an opportunity beyond anything you have ever dreamed of or even imagined in Jesus' name. Pastor Dammy, I believe because you love God, you are faithful, you trust him, you will go far into walking into the destiny God has planned for you and this church. 1 Corinthians 2:9 says, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, and no mind has imagined what God has prepared for those who love him. That will be your portion in Jesus' name. As you embark on this new journey, do not be discouraged, but remember what it says in the following scripture. As you trust God and stay focused on him, he will keep you in perfect peace. And that's from Isaiah 26, verse 3. Another scripture from Proverbs 4:25, the English Standard Version says, let your eyes look directly forward and gaze straight before you. And finally, in Psalm 32, verse 8, God says, I will instruct and teach you in the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eye upon you. The door is open for you to bring the unchurched to the kingdom to win souls. So stay focused on heaven and winning their generations for Christ. This is a door that no man can shut. So walk confidently through the door, walking in God's grace, God's power, God's favor, and God's anointing in Jesus' mighty name. After all, as it says in Romans 8:31, if God be for you, who can be against you? You remain in our prayers. All will be well. God bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Once again, congratulations.
Thank you, Pastor Manita, for your kind words. We love you, man. Thank you, everybody, for joining our great launch today. We've had such an awesome time. I do have a couple announcements before I let you go. Number one, remember that Jesus loves you. If you're tuning in from our YouTube channel, make sure that you hit that button and subscribe. You don't want to miss out. Make sure that you also follow us on all of our social media. We have Instagram, we have Twitter, and also our YouTube channel. You can also visit us at www.weprevail.org. Also, make sure that you tune in next week. We have an awesome group of ministers leading our church next service. Now, just a thanks message from our leading steward, Dammy.
Praise the Lord. We're very grateful, first and foremost, to the owner of the church, the husband of the church, the birther of the church. We're grateful to Jesus, the Christ, the one who will build his church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. We say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And we want to be very clear in expressing our gratitude as well to every single one of you connecting live online and here in person celebrating this beautiful lunch with us. We are grateful. We're really grateful. Thank you so very much indeed to Pastor Kunle Omotoso and Pastor Mrs. Felicia. Thank you so much, sir and ma. To Pastor Manita Fadel, the First Lady RCCG Americas, thank you, ma'am, for the warm hand of fellowship. To all of the worship ministers, Minister Victoria Orenze, Minister Nosa, Minister Sinmidele, Minister Uwana, Etuk, Minister Femi, Okunuga, thank you very much indeed. Thank you to Pastor Niyi, Ojuolape, the residing pastor of the Desire of Nations Church in New York City, out of which PBC has come. I want to thank Andrew Cuevas, a dear friend and dear brother. I want to thank Kalen Stanton, a precious friend to our family. Thank you for praying with us. Thank you for encouraging us. We are grateful to you all. Thank you. We want to simply ask that you continue to keep us in prayers, even as we go about doing the bidding of the Father, and as we navigate uncharted territory regarding a new church model. We are confident of this one thing, that the work belongs to Jesus, and the church belongs to Jesus, the Christ. And so therefore we know that this church will be built by him, and the gates of Hades would never prevail against it. Now, even as we bring this launch service to a close for now, I want to encourage you to please ensure that you are following us live, online, via all of our channels, the YouTube TV, which is this station, the Instagram, and as well as the Twitter. You would see what God is doing through these respective channels. Keep us in your prayers, and we love you. So on behalf of the entire Prevailing and Borderless Church family, I want to say thank you. Thank you for this humbling privilege of your audience, your support, your prayers, your encouragement. It means a great deal. To Jesus Christ alone be all the glory forevermore. Amen. And so here is PBC signing out for now. We shall see you next week at the exact same time, in this exact same space, and in the middle of the week, we continue to study the Word of God daily, as is our practice, on the Zoom platforms. Connect with us on our website to see further details. www.weprevail.org. www.weprevail.org. God bless you, and God keep you. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.